Bombay Hot Radio exclusive.
Guest today, he happens to be a very good friend, and his name is Sholom. And hi, Sholom.
Hi, good morning, guys.
What's going on?
Well, nothing much. Gypsies dragged me here before work, and to be honest, I had a meeting at 9:45 with the director of a huge company, which I'm definitely not going to make today. So I'm all dedicated to you guys for the next half an hour, 45 minutes.
Okay, did I really drag you here, or you were just waiting to come here?
No, I think this is a better way to pass time more than actually doing what I do to earn money. I hope my boss not listening to this.
Hey, you know what? I was getting ready in the morning, and my mom made me awesome breakfast. I sipped on chai and all. And I was leaving home, and she was like, you know, Dipti, I think you should come home early today. And I said, why? What's going on? No, you're going to get stuck in traffic. That's what she tells me. So I was like, okay, I get stuck in traffic every day. It's Mumbai. You know, you have traffic every day. She's like, no, today it's going to be even worse. So I asked her, okay, any specific reason for that? She's like, yes, the reason is there are 30,000 weddings that is happening today in Bombay. Yeah, so if you guys...
Yeah, baby.
What the hell?
Okay, obviously our radio host for the last few weeks hasn't figured out what bomb drops is. Carry on.
Ah, boom!
Ah, you said something that was really good.
I know,
good.
Boom,
so
I know. It was 30,000 weddings.
Yeah,
it is crazy. It's crazy, man. So in case if you guys are going to be working late, either you leave after 12 or you leave before 6 to reach home.
Yeah, baby.
Next song.
Oh, yeah. Sholom has selected... Sholom has selected nice songs that we can play today. Hey, what about Sweeter Sounds Mafia? You know, I'm a sadist. I would want to make those people who bought the passes suffer a bit.
Well, yes, this for a little more suffering, a little more reminiscing, and waiting for the upcoming 22nd show that's completely delayed. And I don't know how they're gonna, how Sweeter Sounds Mafia is gonna pay for all the people who have come down from, I think, half the places in the world. So I think this is just to make you guys want it a little more. We'd like to play Don't You Worry Child, and I think this is one song that really kicks you up in the morning and wants them.
Okay, tell me one thing, Sholom. I think you are one of those people who actually bought the passes and...
Don't remind me. I just hope I get my money back.
You did buy passes?
Are you?
Yeah, I did. Oh, no.
Are you going to get the money back?
I don't know. Technically, I don't care about the money. I just want to hear them play.
They were expensive tickets.
They were really expensive tickets. I had to save for like 5 months for them.
That's bad. That's bad. Okay, so Sweeter Sounds Mafia coming up. Okay.
Yeah, baby. Bombay. Bombay.
Bombay. Bombay.
Okay, guys. So that was Sweeter Sounds Mafia. And... you know, I was just thinking, probably I should have named my show Friday Brandy Time. It's getting really cold in the morning,
Friday,
like I told.
Brandy Time.
Brandy Time. Very soon I'll be sipping on brandy in the morning.
You know what is making you do that?
Yeah?
You know what's making you do this?
What?
This crazy music you want to play fasting in the morning.
Ah,
you know what I'm saying?
That's actually good, you know, but I mean, brandy is good, good for health, right? You know, I came across this article that actually said that beer is good for health. Can you believe that? I've never come across an
beer
article that says chai.
Beer is because it has this thing called malt in it.
Okay.
Malt in it, boy.
Malt.
Very good for stamina. It's good for human body. It's good for human mind. It's good for everything. It's good for corporate advert. If you want a super malt, call 983-356-7174 for your orders. Bombay Hot Radio, baby.
Was that another corporate ad?
I do a lot of corporate ads.
Yeah,
how do you
know,
think
I
you
know.
Make money?
How many chicken orders did you get? How many fried chicken orders did you get?
One from me, one from Nicole, one from Big Penny. Three. We got three. But none of them were paid for. we still need to write messages to their houses and say, please pay your order of chicken.
And you want some extortionists?
Yeah, I do. You want to go out there for me?
No, not me. I have friends who could do that.
You've got friends?
This is Bombay. Anything is possible. You have to keep all kind of friends with you, man.
Alright, so we should tell the special guest in the studio, she has friends. Watch it.
I have to wash my back while going home today.
Nowadays, nobody has friends, but I have friends.
Hey, for your kind of information, I happen to have a lot of friends. And you know what? Since the time I've started coming on radio, I've just had so many friends.
Oh, you ended up having no friends.
No.
I went talked on radio and it was over. My social life.
No. It's the other way around, okay? Stop laughing.
I'm joking, yeah. Get bad. Can I not play around with you first thing in the morning? What's
no.
Wrong?
Okay, you can.
Can't even joke. Shoot.
Yeah. Okay, so, yeah, like I was saying that, you know, beer is good for health, you know. I mean, I think, Sholom, I think even you've read that article, right?
Yeah. Apparently, beer takes down your heart diseases, it takes down your gallstones, it takes down, it's better for your kidneys. My mom has some kidney problems in the last 1 week. I think I should ask her to down some bongs, maybe.
Dude, you should totally stack your fridge with beer.
Yeah. Anyone actually said, you don't even worry about your belly. Don't forget that beer is good for your health. Drink up, you won't have kidney stones. I just met a friend a couple of weeks back, and she's from New York. And she said she used to make beer at home. How cool is that?
Oh, wow. It's like, I would love to have those little, you know, machines that do that, you know. That's just so cool, yeah.
Yeah. And
I know somebody from Kandavali. If you want beer at home, he makes lots of beer. Lots of beer.
Kandivali?
Huh?
Kandivali.
I know people too.
Okay, so yeah, so beer is good for health, right? That's like the highlight of the show, right? Because I haven't come across one article that tells me that chai is good for health. Okay, until and unless it's green tea, of course. But other than that, beer is good. You like beer?
Chai isn't good for health.
I haven't come across an article that gives me facts based on that. So yeah.
If it's Chinese tea.
If it's Chinese tea, yeah. Like I said, Chinese tea or green tea.
I don't know how they come up with a million teas, which are all green. There's like 100 types of green teas. Like how much of green can
there
actually be?
There's a lemon flavor and there is a...
There are medicinal
flavor.
Values. And just go drink beer or make some of your own.
I know, beer.
They don't have to focus on so many green teas if they have the right green tea. Especially in the morning.
Okay, I know exactly what you're talking about.
You're going Goa, no?
Yeah.
Party Goa.
Party!
2012.
Party!
Yeah. Woohoo!
So, okay, that reminds me that now the weekend is here and Friday, it's Friday. I totally empathize with Rebecca Black, you know. I mean, now I know why she was so obsessed with Friday. Friday is an awesome day. So, Sholom, what are your plans for the weekend? Where are you heading?
I was out for a couple of weddings last week. So,
weddings? That sucks.
This weekend, I think I should go and plan on crashing one of the 30,000 weddings that are in town.
Yeah, we should
totally
do that.
I think it's a good idea. If you're laid off work and you don't have anywhere to eat, I think you can just take a right or a left and you'll just bump into anyone. Wear a suit and you'll be good enough.
That'll be so cool.
I've always wanted to do that. Crash a wedding.
Yeah, me too. You know what? Do you want to go together?
I think we should take that
tonight. I think majority of the weddings are going to happen in Ghatkopar area.
Oh my God. Yes.
And for those who don't know, Sholom stays in Ghatkopar.
This is the Gujo capital. Came to Mumbai.
Hello.
Yes.
Do you remember that little competition? I mean, not competition, but awareness program we started last week on your show?
The profile?
Yes.
Uh-huh.
A lot of people are going to get very jealous if you've already selected somebody.
Has anyone even sent in a profile?
Did he send you a profile? Is this where you came from?
Yes. That was supposed to be. That was supposed to be a secret.
Bombay Hot Radio, www.shadi.com, exclusive.
Boom.
I'm sorry, I know. It's so evil us leaving you out in the dark.
In the dark,
this one.
Yeah, he's just wondering what is going on.
When I figure it out, it was funny. Okay.
Yep.
But I hope we are making you guys good. Thanks to the show today, which I really wanted to come on. I did not go for my workout, which I've been doing like once in 2 years. But to get you guys pumping, and if you're still apprehensive to go or not to go to gym, or you really want to get out there and break a sweat because you feel overly fat for the amount of beer you've been drinking, and we've been encouraging you guys to do, I think the next track should definitely get you out of bed and pumping. Well, this one's The Fighter by Gym Class Heroes. It's one of my personal favorites that gets me out and makes me want to pump.
Okay, so let's start jogging.
Get your dumbbells on.
Okay, so I hope you guys are all pumped up with your dumbbells and everything. That was good. That was a good track. What do you think, Shoto? Do you actually work out on this track?
Not that I'm too proud of it, but yes, I do.
Okay, damn cool. Okay, so I'm so proud to be a Mumbai. I just love Mumbai, man. You know, I came across this article. You know, since the time I've been on radio, I've been reading a lot of news. Okay. And I came across this news that said that there was this honest auto driver who saved a marriage. And you know how? This bride was on her way to the marriage hall with like 5 lakh stuff gold in a suitcase.
5 lakhs.
5 lakhs. And she actually left it. She forgot the bag in the rickshaw. And when she reached the hall, she realized that, oh my god, I forgot my suitcase. And her marriage was about to break up because apparently I think it was probably dowry or something like that.
Oh my god.
And this driver actually came back with the suitcase and he
filled with gold.
Exactly. If I would have been in his place, I would have probably run away with that money.
I would have gone got married a couple of times myself with that money.
yeah, but seriously, I mean, this was really cool, you know. I mean, that was really honest of that driver to, you know, actually do something. So there are people like that in Bombay.
Are they your friends?
Yeah. Okay, that also reminds me the fact that today is 30th. That means we have 21 days more to go.
21 days?
Before the world ends, you know. Right?
Are you serious? Oh, yeah.
I mean, what about the man calendar? Boom!
It's actually gonna be the bomb day.
The bomb.
The bomb day.
Yeah, so I mean, 21 days left, you know. I mean, there are so many things that I'm sure we guys still want to
do.
Do
you really believe the world's gonna end in 21 days?
I don't think so, man.
You don't think so?
No.
Because I was gonna make okay, anyone out there who believes the world's gonna end in 21 days, come sign a special contract with me. And if it doesn't end, you belong to me after 21 days. Alright? So
thank God I did not say a yes. He would have made me sign that. You are my slave.
You are the demon in the crossroads.
Yeah, so 21 days left. I mean, see, we don't know what's gonna happen, right? This has been going on in the news since almost 4 years now. I mean, since 2009, I've been listening to it that in 2012, the world is going to end. So, you know, I was just thinking 21 days left and we still have so much to do, you know. I mean, Shalom, what is it that you would like to do before the world ends?
First of all, I didn't know it was 21 days only. So I would have definitely
short
made a
notice,
big list.
Man.
Yeah.
Short notice.
I think one of the few, I never imagined to come on radio, to be very honest.
Yeah, you should totally thank me, man.
Yeah, you crossed out one thing on my list. I think the second thing would be to get my money back for my tickets to Swedish House Mafia. That doesn't happen. Because I think that's happening on the 22nd. So one day before, if I'm going to pop.
Are you serious?
Yep.
I thought they were smart and they had shifted the date to Jan.
Oh, now that's why I know why they shifted the 22nd.
Exactly. See, they don't have to pay you back.
Yeah.
Yeah, it's crazy. So what more would you want to do?
I would definitely like to go deep sea diving with the biggest great white shark in the world. I know that sounds really scary because...
You would die before 21 days would get over.
Yeah, so basically I'm going to die anyway, so why not just try it out, you know?
So I think you should try that on the last day, you know, probably on the 21st day.
On the 20th.
Just to be on
20th midnight.
Yeah, 28th midnight sounds good, yeah.
Well, something would be like all the dangerous stuff, like jumping out of a plane or... I think I should visit Kim Kardashian's house. Yeah.
So what?
Wait a minute, I just used my brain. Why 21 days? Do you know what a day is in 21 days?
What?
What's the date in 21 days? What's today's date?
Today's 30th.
So, what's the date on the 21st? What is the day on the 21 days? The 21st, right?
The 21st,
yeah.
Right? Or the 22nd or the 20th?
It's the 20th.
Right, so how is that relevant to the end of the world?
Because according to the Mayan,
21st of December 2012.
Mark it in your calendar.
Like, isn't it supposed to be the 1st of January or the 31st of December?
I know, dude. I have plans.
For this appeal to work,
I know,
really,
yeah.
To actually scare people.
Yeah. Nice. I don't know. You know what? I have actually planned for a good 31st party.
Yeah.
So the world. Better not end, yeah.
It should be more like a 21st party now instead of a
21st
party.
Yeah, I know, we
party.
All should have.
First of all, two questions.
Mm-hmm.
Isn't Jesus supposed to be coming back at some point?
Is it?
Isn't Jesus supposed to be coming back at some point?
It's high time he books his
ticket. Yeah, no. Someone told me that he was supposed to ring again and come talk to us again at some point. And then second question, which I've always wondered. No offense to anyone out there, trust me. Who have the Hindus got coming back to us? I asked my mom this the other day. Wait a minute, who are we waiting for? Why are we alive? Why are we sitting here waiting for someone? Get it? Never mind.
Yeah, actually,
sure.
that's
to relevance to all the religions that we're talking about and all the prophecies. Okay, 21st. What relevance does that really have to anything? Tell me this. Unless we're playing a game of 21 with you.
Blackjack. Okay, so
well, going for the theme that of the 21-day deadline that we have, I think I have a pretty apt track for the deadline to go get it, and then when 21 days are left. I have this very pumping track from Afrojack featuring Shramal Naji. It's called "Can't Stop Me Now." So I think this should be the anthem song for the 21st night.
Ooh.
When it's all gonna come down. I hope you guys like this track.
We will like this
Afrojack.
Track. And we're all very rude here. We can't get jobs in other places. That's why we built our own radio station and start talking to ourselves. So, Jack, you can cut in whenever you want. Let's just go in and say, bye. Go ahead, did you get it? Alright, so what are we listening to? Afrojack, Can't Stop Me Now.
Yep.
On Bombay Hot Radio. Is that right, Dipti?
Oh, yeah.
Yes, boss.
Yeah, baby.
Bombay Hot Radio.
Yeah, baby.
Bombay Hot Radio.
Okay.
That was a good track.
Dipti was taking pictures for Facebook, which you're going to see in a minute. With some notorious smiles going on. So she didn't realize that the song had finished. She didn't want to tell me the song had finished.
Okay, I also did not expect you to get over so fast. I'm busy posing for a pig.
And we talked.
Pig.
What?
You're busy
taking a picture.
I thought you said I was busy posing for a pig.
For a pig. No.
Okay. Go on.
Talking about cutting, being on chai time, Dipti, have you had a chance to have your morning tea? Or you just stormed out of bed and just reached
out? No, let's. Can we skip that topic?
Why skip the topic about breakfast?
No,
you
okay.
Guys are doing such a great show. I'm about to buy everyone McDonald's breakfast.
Yay!
Okay, that's too many yays. I counted, that's way too much of a budget. Alright.
Let's cut down on the cost, no? You're offering too many freebies.
What did you say? I'm sorry. What did you say?
Even my girlfriend makes fried chicken and then I have to go and give it away
for
free.
You have a girlfriend?
No, that's what Sin would say.
That's what Sin would say.
Really, girlfriend?
Shut up.
Wow, empty.
But yeah, hey.
All the people who applied for the shadi.com interview, competition for
competition.
50. This is why it's not working. Because she has a girlfriend. So
okay.
Tell us about your girlfriend. Is she the one who's getting married?
I think she's definitely one of the 20,000.
I'm so stunned. I actually don't have anything to say.
Big shout out to Dipti's girlfriend who's getting married next week, is it?
No, she's getting married in February.
It's one of the 30,000.
Oh, so
weddings.
That is your girlfriend now.
Okay, she is a very good friend of mine, okay? Stop doing that to me. That's not fair.
Now you can't
team up. Sholom, you're on my side.
But now at least I know which wedding to crash now. Now at least I know which wedding to crash now.
Yeah.
Okay, Sholom, this is your last show. I'm not getting you back.
Okay.
Dipti, this is your last show.
You guys are mean. Anyway, Sholom, you know what? One of my friends is interested in going out with you. I mean, she just told me that you sound so hot.
Yeah, well, as they say, looks are deceptive, but I wouldn't mind trying it.
Yeah, and since the world ending in 21 days,
yeah, I know.
All, I mean,
since the world is ending in 21 days, and I've been sitting on this stupid radio show for like 5 months now, why no one for find me attractive? Hello.
Yeah.
This sexy guy comes in the studio for the first day, and it's like Shadow Khan popping up. You get me? We have like ambassadors and stuff outside the building for some reason. We're waiting. What is good?
I think that's the first time someone has actually wanted to go out with me. So, having 21 days left, I would definitely be definitely one of my get.
I was just thinking, wow,
no
way
pun intended.
Your future's becoming bright.
I think this is working more than the shadi.com thing.
Shadi.com. Oof.
Hello.
Marriages. Yes. Yeah, I am talking.
Marriages.
Marriages. I know.
Alright, so what's the next song?
Yeah. Okay.
Do I have to keep that groove alive for you? Seriously.
Yeah, come on, I mean, it's good. We need someone who can take care of that, right?
You can sit there and just say hi, it's good.
I'm just sitting here talking.
Oh, marriage is right. Wait 1 minute. Boom.
Boom.
I know everyone don't know what's going on in the studio. Here, hold this. Keep it with them. I'm trying to make furniture right now in the studio because our studio really hasn't got any space. You get me? Boom. New corporate. That's why we have so many corporate ads.
Right.
No, actually, I'll
be okay.
Really nice.
Sholom, which track?
Okay, the next song that I'd like to play for you guys is Hall of Fame, The Script by Will and Hall of Fame. This is one song I think will actually tone it down a little for you guys and actually make you think and you go a little into the phase for the 21 days that you should think about during these couple of minutes of the track. So, let me know how you like it. Boom.
Boom.
Yeah, baby.
Rock, great.
Okay, that was the script. Nice song. Okay, so we are almost coming to the end of the show. We still have like 5-10 minutes more to go.
5-10 minutes?
Yeah.
Are you guys?
We've got another 15 to 20 minutes.
Dude, you know what? You forget. We have jobs to go to.
I know.
And you don't pay us.
What time did you come to this job?
8:45. And we went on air at 9:22 because of you.
Why because of me? I was up pretty quickly.
Yeah. I have to wait for 10 minutes every day outside.
Before you open the door.
I'm getting
really hungry. I mean, I am definitely stepped out without having good bite. I feel like
very pumped up for the show, man.
Some nice, I don't know, Kima, what's your favorite breakfast?
I like bun masala. I like pancakes.
Yeah? Where do you think we can get some? Please tell everyone out there where we can get some good bun masala in Bombay.
Bun masala in Bombay. Bun masala. I think Mocha Mojo, which is right around the corner over here.
Yeah.
that has pretty good breakfast.
No, when we were in college, there used to be this really, really awesome guy outside Churchgate Station who used to sell the best bun muska for like $5 and with the best cutting chai ever.
Is this the same guy who also sells bun muska at 5 in the morning?
No, this guy, the same guy.
I think I've been there. Yeah, it's pretty good. Yeah, it's pretty good. Really nice. And you know those small Irani cafes, you know, they also serve good stuff. Yeah, good stuff. There is this Madras cafe that has a very good South Indian breakfast.
Yeah, that's pretty famous.
I mean, even if you go at 8 in the morning, you still have to wait.
For a queue.
Yeah, it's crazy, man. It's crazy. My friends totally love Madras Cafe. And they would probably wake me up on a Sunday morning. Like, get out of bed. Let's go. Let's go to Madras Cafe and have breakfast.
Let us go for some idli.
Idli. Yeah.
Well, people who are more up for completely continental, but a totally hardcore Iranian breakfast with a lot of keema and pao.
Sounds heavy.
Do you know where to get that in Bandra? Mehbub Studio. Good luck.
Yeah?
Good luck. Yeah, I know. You had spoken about this last time also. I need to go there.
I think I have a better place that beats that. This is somewhere on Matunga outside Belinka College. And this, it's called, I'm not sure what the name of the restaurant is. I think it's Gulshan or something. Bang opposite the Gymkhana. And this is the most tastiest keema pao with peas and lime spread over. It's mouth-watering delicious.
I think
there's a swimming pool here.
You're drooling. Okay.
I know what I'm going to hit on the way back home.
Breakfast time, very hard for everyone here. Alright, you know what we should do?
What?
She said with Bombay Hot Radio, we should start going and exploiting the restaurants and being like, yo, you need to feed us or you get a bad review.
at least that way, if not money, we could get free food, right?
Yeah.
We can feed ourselves.
KFC, you ever mess with me again, I'm coming for you. Alright, I'll be like, yo, you know who I work for? Bombay Hot Radio. I'll put you all over.
Crazy.
Oh my
but you know, please, KFC, I love KFC. It's pretty good.
Wow, yeah, but
chicken bucket.
Police at the door?
Oh, I'm just surfing. Yeah, can you see this? Kim Kardashian. She's top Justin Bieber in the most Google. I don't know, I'm obsessed with her. I don't know.
Yeah,
maybe she's really hot.
Okay,
I think I don't want to meet her.
Okay, you're wondering why Kim Kardashian
is the most. No, I'm not one
person above Justin Bieber.
I was wondering how Justin Bieber is the most Googled person above her.
He is?
He was, yeah, and she topped him.
Really?
By a couple of notches.
That's crazy.
Yeah.
Whoa.
Wow. There's a lot of dipty doshies Googling Justin Bieber and Justin Bieber.
Oh, shut up. I don't like him.
You don't?
No. Crazy.
No, okay, Dipti, what if you were the most Googled person in the world?
I would feel.
I think you're the most Google most searched for person on Shadi.com for sure.
No, wait. Not only Shadi.com. There is Vaishnav Matrimony.
I
and
laugh.
Then there is Simply Married.com.
How do you know?
No, I'm
because she ranks number one.
Yeah.
What do you call
I'm a premium okay. member.
What do you call the person who gets you married in India?
The person who arranges
like
the middleman.
No, not like the middleman. Arranges the marriage show. The person who gets you married. Like the priest
The pundit.
So we need to make a new website called makemeyourpundit.com.
Ah, nice. Good idea.
Makemeyourpundit.com.
Shall we start gathering database of all the pundits that we have?
I think I should.
Since everything in the world is going to become internet-wise anyway, we might as well start collecting our .coms.
Hey, you know what?
We should have done that like 20 years ago.
Being
I don't know what we've been doing.
Being a Gujarati, I've already started planning it in my head, you know. I think that's a very good idea.
What if we started planning the Gujaratis? The awesomeness of the Gujaratis. What if they started planning now? Tell me.
No, I don't think any Gujarati is listening to this track. I mean, to the show right now.
No, I know a few Gujaratis who are.
Yeah?
A few Gujaratis will be hella pissed off with me, but it's all good. It's all good. You know what I mean? Gujaratis, we exist to be pissed off. You gotta understand that. You go to any Gujarati household, all you hear is gossip and complaints.
Not in my house, okay?
But that's because you're a different Gujarati, like me. I'm a different Gujarati.
We are little...
Like most Gujaratis eat sweet, no?
Uh-huh.
We like really spicy. We don't like sweet at all.
Right.
So different.
We are different.
We're evolved Gujaratis.
Evolved.
International Gujarati.
International.
They know.
I have a Guju in the studio who doesn't even know how to speak Gujarati.
Yeah. And you know what? I won't say anything about the Maharashtrians because I'm not. But I'm a Gujarati, so I can say whatever I want about them. Anything. No matter.
Okay, so I think it's about time we need to leave for our jobs.
Real jobs?
Yeah, jobs. Hello. Hello.
What hello?
Who's going to replace your next 15 minutes?
We can play some
nice
songs.
You think I have
songs?
A substitute who's just going to come in and say, hello, this is... And we are substituting.
You know...
On a child show. So that she can go to work. Yes.
You know what I can do is...
You want me
to
order your Meru cab or something?
Sorry?
You want me to order a Meru cab or something?
No, I have my own car.
Oh, wow.
Yeah, man.
Dipti Doshi show. Kya baat. See, she's a Gujarati.
Yeah, I'm a Gujarati.
So what are you, by the way?
I'm a Protestant. I'm half Jew and half Christian.
You're a Protestant.
Yes, a Protestant against everything.
You know, I mean, Sin doesn't know this, but even I'm half Christian.
You're half Christian too? Yeah,
yeah, my mom is a Catholic.
Oh, the different cocktails that people got into.
Yeah.
What is up with India? Is it like the silent Christian takeover?
Did you hear that?
It's the most silent takeover ever. Like, we just apparently are. Nobody came us and made us become anything. Nobody said you have to or you're going to die. Like, we're just doing it. Ridiculous.
Okay, so you know what I can do is I could probably leave the studio and then, you know, call in as a caller and then continue for the next 5 minutes.
Now, before we get any more genius ideas, we're going to let her go to work and use her genius ideas where it counts.
Thank you so much.
Good plan, no?
Okay, shalom.
Okay, so I think I'm going to take your leave too. I want to play this next track for y'all. It's called The Riddle by Preziso and Marvin. It's quite a nippy one. I hope you like it.
Okay, so this is Friday Chai Time and we had even more fun today. I mean, my third show and I think this is really awesome. Shalom, it was really awesome to have you on the show.
Thank you. It was very nice.
I'm hoping that we can make a good team.
Definitely.
And host the show again. And, another thing that I would want to tell is that go on.
Before that, ask your friend to text me.
Yes. My friend is in love with your voice, and she's interested in going out with you. So
7:30, big nasty. Be there.
See, we will hook it up on Bombay Hot Radio. That's what we call Bombay Hot Radio.
Hot. Yeah, so Yashi, if you're listening, Shorom will meet you at 7:30 at Big Nasty today. So, be there.
Yeah, but do you know what? You know, I'm serious. Like, this never happened on Bombay Hot Radio. It just sounds like some stalker. Yes. Big nasty.
7:30,
I will be there.
Chalo, jate hai.
That's not what we look like when we will be there. I've been a guy in a yellow outfit.
Okay, yeah.
iPhone.
Yeah, she. Sholom is going to stand with a red rose in his hand. That's how you could, you'll be able to recognize him.
Oh my god.
I'm going to be standing outside Big Nasty, not Rambo Circus.
I will meet you at the Big Nasty.
Okay, so...
I don't think Shoram's going to go for work. He's going to go and buy himself a new suit. Yeah. Go and get himself a shade.
Yeah.
I can picture the guy in the video of the Gangnam Chai in the yellow suit who's trying to hustle with Psy. With the shades.
Hey, you know what? We should only play that song, Gangnam Style. Okay, maybe not today. Probably some other day. Don't look at me that way.
I tell you what.
Yes.
You also join all the national retards of the world. And Gangnam Style on. More power to the retards.
Okay, so I would want to inform all my listeners that next Friday I'm not here.
Woohoo!
I'll be partying in Goa. I'll be attending David Guetta's show on the end.
I get to sleep.
Yeah, you get to sleep. Yeah, yes. Yeah, that's true. That's true. Yeah.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Are we done now?
Yes, we are done.
Show is done now.
Yes. So I'll see you guys next Friday. Do tune in. We'll have some more fun, and I'll convince Sholom to come again.
It'll be really nice to come again.
Yeah.
It was nice talking to you guys. I hope you have a great day, and you should definitely jam on the Kema Pao, and beware if you meet Dipti at the David Guetta concert on the 8th of December. Yeah, he'll be roaming around the shadi.com board, so it's easy to spot her.
I have my biodatas ready, and I'll have a copy of my biodata just to hand it out to whoever is interested.
So you have any brothers, sisters want to get hooked up between the age of...
We have a family representative. their presence to talk to any potential
suitor. Yeah. So this is another corporate ad, you know. So.
So are you guys signing out?
Yes, we're signing out. Adios.
Bye bye, people. Buenos dias.
Yes.
From shadi.com, exclusive.
Yeah, baby.